Hello, my friends, and welcome to part 10. Just making sure the mic's on, yes. Part 10 of the cigar box guitar build project. I really hope this is going to be the last one, but who knows? Okay, so in the previous video, I'd fitted the bridge and the strap button. Thank you. And in this one, I'm fitting the tuners and the strings and the string trees and then getting it set up. So, okay, yeah, I did do a little bit off camera. All I did was I just put the tuners in so that I could line up and mark and drill the holes for the screws. So I haven't done anything more than that. So I want the nuts fairly tight to stop them moving around, which they are at the moment. So I've got my tiny little screws, and I'm going to put a little dab of wax. This is actually beeswax mixed with boiled linseed oil to help. Whenever you put new screws into new holes, you always want to give yourself a little bit of a helping hand, and using a little bit of wax on them, you can use candle wax or Vaseline or anything like that, will just help them ease them into the wood, and they're not going to come loose. So let me just zoom in. Okay, so put the screws in first, little blob of wax on the end of the screw. Again, you don't need a lot, just to kind of help to ease the screw into the fresh hole in the wood. Right, my little screwdriver. This is a bit of a finicky job, but it should be okay. Okay, here goes the first one. Yeah, I mean, I can feel it's quite tight, so, you know, without that wax, I'd be having a bit of a problem getting that in, but that's going in nicely. So the last thing you want to do is round off these screw heads, because if you need to change the tuners or take them out for any reason, it becomes almost impossible. And unlike the bridge and the strap button, I'm not putting glue on these, because I want these to be easily removable if necessary. And if I glue these in, when you try and take them out, you will just, you know, burr up the heads and you won't be able to get them out at all. Okay, that's the first one. And a little bit more on there, I think. It felt a bit tight, that first one going in towards the end. Okay. And again, you know, I've got this wax all over my fingers. It's going to get all over the headstock and everything else, but it's actually good for wood. Beeswax and boiled linseed oil. It's going to do it no harm whatsoever. Okay, that second one's going in a fair bit easier. That's good. So the difference there was I put the wax all the way up the shaft of the screw rather than just on the end. And that's made life quite a bit easier. Okay, good. One more. Yeah. Well, no, I do like beeswax and boiled linseed oil, but they are messy. There's no doubt about that. Screw going in now. There we go. Just make sure the other two are tight without rounding them off. There we go. Okay. So that's the focus. Okay, that's the tuners in with the screws. So now I turn it over and just make sure these nuts are tight on the top. Now you don't over tighten these, you can easily strip out the threads. Just barely more than finger tight, really. Don't push your luck with these because they will strip or break easily. Okay. I mean, I have got three spares if that did happen, but it's just a pain in the bum, isn't it? Right, okay, so I think next we're ready to put the strings in, so let me just zoom out. Which way round shall I do this? Actually, before I do anything else, these other three screws, I'll just put those back in the bag so that they don't get lost. One, two, and three. I might need to... Right, so strings. As I said, I've got 2, 3, and 4 string, which is effectively the B, G, and D string. Is that right? Yes. So the gauges are, for those of you that are interested, the thickest string is going to be is a 32 thousandths of an inch. The middle string is 25 thousandths of an inch, and the treble string, as it were, is 15 thousandths of an inch. So, like I said, it's effectively strings 2, 3, and 4 of a guitar, although the tuning of this is effectively closer to 3, 4, and 5 strings of a guitar. But, you know, you don't get the tension. So these are the ones I'm going with. Right, let me start by turning this around and see. Yeah, it's this tuner posts. That'll tighten up. Right, let's see if I can zoom back in there. Yeah, that's not too bad when it focuses. Okay, so got to remember this is a right-handed instrument, not for me. So let's start with the middle string, just to make it easy. No, I'm going to start with the bass string. Actually, it doesn't matter at this stage. Okay. So brand new strings. I do have some used strings, but what's the point? You know, I save some of the used strings, not all of them. I do save some that are still in good condition for doing some of these projects, but not for this. Okay, so the string goes through a hole in the bottom of the bridge, and then it goes up through the adjuster. I'll just put it that way first. It goes up. Right, 1 second, I've got to loosen off that adjuster. Okay, so it goes through a hole in the back of the bridge, then underneath and up through the adjuster. It's a little bit fiddly, especially when you can't see. 1 second. I'm sure some of you are shouting at the screen, "You're doing it wrong! I don't care." Oh, come on, there we go. So through the adjuster and then over the front top edge of it. Okay, I'm going to put all the strings in first, then I'll turn it around and show you how I attach them to the tuner. Just want to get them all in first. Now, one of those things again on camera. I can't even unwind the screen. There we go. Is it? Yeah. I wound this up a bit too good. Here we go. Right. So that's the middle string. So as I said, this is going to be tuned GDG. It's known as open G tuning, which means even without fretting it, you when you play all three strings together, you've got a G chord. And it's good for bar chords, and it's much easier to play chords on this than a regular guitar because you've only got three strings. Why is that being such an awkward what's a name? I know why, because I've got the camera on. I was doing it off camera, I'd have had a finish by now. Okay. Keep that string, there we go, that's that one. Okay. And the treble string. One thing you don't want to do with these guitar strings is stab your finger with the end of it. Ask me how I know. Ah, crikey, does that hurt. Yeah. I've only done it a couple of times. And the first time I did it, I wanted my mum. Bloody horrible, really, really painful. Because it, I mean, especially the, you know, like the lower gauge strings, they're like syringe needles and they really do pierce your skin easily, so be careful. Right, come on, don't mess me about last string. Okay. Tweezers here somewhere, there we go. That'll help me a bit. There we go. Right, okay, so that's all the strings in. Now I'm gonna turn it around and show you how I actually string the strings up to the tuners. That way. Okay. I know you're not going to see perfectly what I'm doing, but you should get the idea. So, start with the bass string. So I bring that up and to the, how would I say it, the outside of the tuner, okay, and wrap it around. One. About 1.5 times should be enough for that one. So around the post 1.5 times so that the winds go up the post, then push the end of the string through the hole and pull it taut. Pull it taut, he says. I didn't think of this. Often these new tuners, especially the cheaper ones, the hole that the string goes through on the tuner post, sometimes it's got a little bit of a burr on it, and the string will catch, and I should have thought about that. It will file out first, but actually it's going alright. So that's fine. Okay. So now, yeah, you can't really see what I'm doing. So I'm just holding this string. Oh, this is impossible. Holding the string down just before the post, and then wind the tune around to tighten it up. Okay. So I'm not going to do them too tight just yet because I need to fit the string trees as well. And how are we doing for time?
Not great.
Okay, so just plug in the second one. So again, pull the string up to the outside of the post. Wrap it around one. I'll go twice with this one. It's a thinner string. There's a hole. Boy. Come on. it up, hold the string down just in front of the tuning post and wind it on a bit. Okay, a little bit more just to hold the tension so it doesn't move around everywhere. Okay. Now, the treble string is an unwound string. The other two strings are wound. So I want to be careful that this is not going to slip. So first of all, I'm going to wrap it around one, two, three times. Three times. Then, you can't see what I'm doing, but when I push the string through the hole in the tuning post, so push that through first, and then I put the end of the string underneath the last loop, which will kind of lock it in place. So it goes underneath the last loop that goes around the post, if that makes sense. I wish I could show you better what I'm doing, but I can't. Okay, and then pull it taut. And as I said, that then locks it in place. Okay, wind it on. Just go on that notch first. Okay, all round and round it goes. Then it stops, nobody knows. Right, okay, so that's all of the strings on. They're not up to tension yet, because as I said, I need to fit the string trees. And I do need to do that before I start to try and set it up, because the strings just won't stay in place otherwise. Time, okay, not bad. Right, so, I think I am going to nip off the ends of the strings, because they're going to be in my way for doing these string trees. So let me just find my small nippers. Just going to nip off the ends of the strings, let's see, because they're in my way at the moment, so it's not going to help me at all. One, two, and three. Okay. Right, string trees. Just zoom in a bit more. Okay. Yeah, it's still going to be a bit awkward for you to see what I'm doing here. Let's just get them out first. So, the idea of the string trees, it's not going to focus, but it's basically a base with a bar that goes through and a wheel at each end of that, and the strings go underneath those wheels to keep them in place, and also to help them glide where they're supposed to go. So I need to loosen off these strings a little bit first before I can fit those. And the placement of these is pretty crucial. You want them to be straight, so the string goes straight, and in line, basically. Right, that looks pretty good. That. So we need a pencil to mark where that is. Am I happy with that? I'm happy with that. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, so I'll just mark that with a pencil. Yep. Okay, so drill. Where's my drill? There he is. So the drill bit I have in there should be, yeah, that's the right size. Okay, so here goes the first one. Wait, careful. Okay. That was my wax. pretty fiddly. And once again, I'm not gluing these in, I'm putting a little bit of wax on to help them in, but these need to be easily removable again if necessary, as with the tuners. So, can't really see that, but let me zoom out a bit. That's in. Okay, so that's the first of the string trees fitted. You can see what it actually does. It brings the string down to the level of the tuning post. Okay, so exactly the same with the other one. So, let's make sure I'm happy with the position. That's good. Okay. Let's not drill through that string tree. Uh-oh. That was just about to break through there. Maybe not. Felt like I could feel it breaking through. There's loads of room there. What am I talking about? Come on. Make a commitment now. And it didn't go through. Woohoo! Right. I really would like to get this set up in this video, but it ain't gonna happen. I can't believe it. never mind. We're almost there, to be honest. I mean, you know, this is the last bit of hardware to go on. So it really is just setting up after this. I am gonna record it, so it's gonna be an 11th video. Sure, why not? Ow. Said it before and I'll say it again. Whenever there's gonna be something that goes wrong or it just takes ages to do, it's always gonna be when the camera's rolling. It's just the way it is. Murphy's Law, I think some people say. Think of better names. Right, come on. There we go. In you go, come on. All the way. And there it is, all finished. So that's the two string trees on, the tuners, the strings, as I said, you can see what those string trees do for the strings. Bridge and saddles, strap button. Okay, so that is it built. Let me zoom out. So that's the thing built, okay? It's all together, all the hardware's on. So I'm gonna do one more video, which is a setup of this instrument, because it's gonna take a little while, but it shouldn't be too bad. Okay, so I'd like to thank you all for watching. Please give a thumbs up, subscribe, hit the notification bell, all the rest of it, and we will see you in part 11. Peace out.